All right, shalom, mom, shalom, mom. First and foremost, I want to send all praises and glory to Kal Halayim La, Obanawa, Yahweh, Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashim, Makakadash, Barakatai. Double honors to the men of the Lord who I've taught of the shoes for many, many years. This is your brother, Kabash Kabash, coming at you with another lesson. And I know it looks like I shaved my head, brothers, but I didn't shave it. Still got some particles here at the top. You feel me? So, you know, I know we shouldn't have a bald head, but I know on camera, it looks like I have a bald head, but I don't. I just had my barber come over to my crib. I told him to take it all off. He didn't take no razor to my head or nothing. He only took the clippers, all right? But I just want to let y'all know before I start because, you know, the camera can be deceiving sometimes, you know? You know, sometimes these all devices can, you know, create an illusion. So I just wanted to point that out, all right? So no bald heads on this end, okay? Let's go into the book of Psalms. And, you know, I just got to reading the book of Job, which was a very inspirational book, man. You know, because I'm fighting my eczema right now. My eczema has came back 100 times worse because I usually just have it on my arms, or on my hand, and a little bit on my feet. But now it's like all over my body. I don't know if you can see it, but I put some oil on earlier. But, you know, when I be doing my lessons, when I be going out, you know, I be scratching a lot, you feel me? And as a matter of fact, I'm scratching my legs right now. You know, I pulled the oil on, but that eczema has been kicking my behind. And at the end of this, that book, man, what it has taught me is that we cannot question the Most High. You know, Wolfie paraphrasing, Job said he had nothing more to say. You know, he had nothing more to say. You know, so when the Most High takes us through this persecution, you know, what can we say? He's creator of good, a creator of evil. He does all things. And the Most High was certainly boasting himself up in the book of Job, you know? So, you know, brothers, I don't know what type of infirmities you're going through or any type of sickness you're going through, but at the end of the day, we can't say anything. You know, we just got to continue to praise the Most High. Tell the Most High, I know I've sinned. I'm falling short of your glory. And I give all praises to you. That's all you can say, man. You give all praises to the Most High. All right? So let's go into the book of Psalms, chapter 1. And I think we're just going to stick with those verses. It says, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly. You see, when you're in this truth, man, you cannot walk in the counsel of the ungodly. Okay? I mean, yeah, you can have people you hang out with every now and then or, you know, but if they start to do ungodly things like sleeping with another man's wife or talking about ungodly things, you know, you might want to cut yourself off from them, you know. You know, some people that I know, you know what I'm saying, have said those things, or I took that man's wife or I took that man's girlfriend or did this, did that or whatever, you know. But at the end of the day, man, you can't surround yourself with ungodly people. Okay, because that's a negative energy. Okay. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. Gotta have that negativity away from you, man. If they're not righteous, don't be with them. Now I'm gonna put it like this: there are some people in your life that are coachable, and they see the way you move. You're a role model for them, you know. I'm in the process with that now with one of my homeboys right now. He's seeing how I move, how I worship the Most High. And, you know, he's starting to say all praises to the Most High. He sees me when I take my hat off. He sees me when I say all praises to the Most High in my Instagram videos, you know. Okay, verse 2. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doeth he meditate day and night. Now, that goes back to another verse. Seek ye first the kingdom of the Most High and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. All right. Now, if you delight yourself in the Lord, delight yourself in his law, his righteousness. All right. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. Wait a minute. Verse 3. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth his fruit in season. His leaf also shall not wither, and And whosoever doeth, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. Okay? So what if you are in the Most High, look at Job, look at Abraham. Look at what they did. They prospered, you know? Job, Abraham, you know? I mean, yeah, Job went through a lot. But at the end of the day, what did the Most High say? What did it say in the scriptures? His latter days were better than his beginnings or something like that. I won't paraphrase it, you know? And that brings me to another verse too. It says, and he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. There's one verse where it says in the scriptures, certain seeds should not be planted in the path or something like that. Let me see if I can see it. Seeds, if I can find it here. Seeds planted in the path. King James Version. Let me see if I can find it. Okay. What's that? Matthew. Okay. This is the book of Matthew chapter 13, starting at verse 4. And when he sowed, some seeds fell by the wayside, and the fowls came up and devoured them. I think that's the, let me see if I can find it. It was at Matthew 13. Let me see if I can find that. Because sometimes I get my Bible verses mixed up. But see, when you in the shoot, you want to be planted by the riverside. You know what I'm saying? Because you know, if you're planted by the riverside and how strong that current is, you know, if you planted by the riverside, definitely you're going to have strong roots. Okay. Let me see. 13. So basically what I'm trying to say is that you got to have a strong foundation in this truth, man. You know, you got to have a strong foundation in this truth. All right. That's why it's important not to let, not to hang out around a lot of ungodly people. Okay. Let's see. All right. This is the book of Matthew chapter 13, verse 1. The same day Yahweh Shai went out. Selakia. The same day went Yahweh Shai out of the house and sat by the seaside. And great multitudes gathered to him, so that he went into a ship and sat. The whole multitude stood on the shore, and he spake many things unto them in parable, saying, behold, a shower went forth to sow. And he sowed some seeds by the wayside, and fowls came to devour them. Some fell in stony places, where they had not much earth, and forthwith they sprung up, because they had no deepness in the earth. Okay? Now, sometimes you can come in this truth and sprout up real quickly. You know what I'm saying? But just because you sprout up so quickly don't mean you have a strong foundation. All right? Because you know how some plants, they can just sprout up just like that. You know what I'm saying? But if you're not rooted in this truth, if you're not rooted, then you're definitely going to wither away real quick. Okay? Let me continue to read. It says, verse 5, some fell upon stony places, and they had not much earth. And forthwith they sprung up, because they had no deepness of the earth. Okay. And some fell among thorns and sprung up and choked them. Let me read that again. And some fell among thorns and the thorns sprung up and choked them. Okay. So that's why it's important not to hang around negative people when it comes to this truth, unrighteous people when it comes to this truth, okay? Because trust me, you might have some people be like, oh, why you in that truth? You know, they're thorns, you know? They're thorns. If you're going to put forth that much negativity, you a thorn, all right? And some fell, okay, but others fell into good ground and brought forth fruit, okay? Brought forth fruit. What? Okay, now let's go back to Psalms 1. Let's go back to Psalms 1. Okay. What did it say? It says, and he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. His leaf also shall not wither. Whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. So that's what we want to do. Whatever we doeth, because we seek ye first the kingdom of the Most High and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto us. Okay? So basically, what I'm getting from this, we have to put forth the will of the Most High. All right? And whatever we do within the will of the Most High, we'll prosper. Okay? Along with some other things too, you know what I'm saying? But whatever will we do with the Most High, as long as we're rooted in a certain way, as long as we plant our seed in good ground, it will prosper. Our main objective is to do what? Prophesy this truth. To go out among the highways and the hedges. You know, we are fishers among men. That's what we want. We want the Most High. I mean, Yahweh Shai said, I will make you fishers among men. How did he do that? Well, he left us the comforter when he went up to the heavens. All right. But anyway, that's going to be it. Just wanting to go over something simple. I want to give all praises and glory to Kol Halah Yilah, Obinawa Yahweh, Bahashem Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Makar Kadash Barakatah. Till next time, Shalom. All praises to the Most High. Shalom.